Welcome to Pilates Shorts. Pilates Shorts are short videos designed to be done after you've warmed up your body. So today's focus is going to be on the glutes. We're going to work all on one side, splice it with a little bit of abdominals, and then work all on the other side. We're going to start on all fours. So go ahead into your quadruped position. Unlock your elbows and push out strongly through the shoulders. Moves are going to be for about 45 seconds, and then we'll move on to the next move. Starting with my right leg, I'm going to do hip circles. So I'm going to circle back, two, three, four, and then bring it forward. Forward, two, three, four. So we're using this back and forth as a warm-up to the joint and to start focusing on the muscle group that we're going to be working, which is our glutes. Good, and reverse. Four and four. Light weight through the hands. And I want you to lead with your knee. So let your foot be along for the ride and let your knee kind of guide the motion. When we're up and out to the side, we want the knee to be slightly higher than the foot. You keep counting your four and then reverse. All right, we're gonna progress this exercise to bring the same hand behind the back open up, and we're just gonna do circles up and out to the back. Lift with the knee. As you lift up here, squeeze that stance glute, grow tall. Abdominals are scooped in and up. They act as our brake or our counter force. Visualize that circle that you're making as if you're drawing on the wall with the kneecap. If you're feeling too much weight in the hand, I want you to pull your weight back onto your stance leg. Hold this leg at the top, extend it back, toe pointed, facing to the screen, lift. Long lever lift. Reach up with the side body, strong through the armpit muscles, open chest. The hand on the back serves as feedback. You don't want to overarch, and you want to feel it in the outside glute. Squeeze your butt as you lift. Up, up. Keep pointing the toe, reaching it long. You can feel it in the stance leg already, but big time outside glute. By the end of today, we're going to work your glutes in all ranges. Up, up, up. Last two. Last one, back down onto all fours, same leg behind. I want you to cross behind you and tap it on the outside. Lift up and around and tap it to the outside of the mat. So it's as if you're making a half circle, a rainbow, whatever you'd like to use. Same form, toe pointed, leg reaching long. The tendency is for the body to sway and counter. Try to keep your core between shoulders and hips perfectly still. As you reach up, keep it out of the back and into the glute. You got a little bit left. Hold that leg in line with you. Reach it long. You're going to bring it to the outside, maybe about 2 inches outside of the mat, and then hug it into the center. Out and in. Out and in. Resist the urge to counter with the upper body. Same thing. Control. As you hug it in, turn on those inner thighs. Inhale out. Exhale, center. Keep scooping up your lower abdominals. You can imagine here that you're sliding your foot back and forth on a shelf behind you. Keep it at that same level. right in line with your hips. We're almost there. Last one. Lower to your opposite elbow, forearm parallel to the mat. Cross the ankles behind, and then lift it up and behind you. Curtsy reach. Whew. Once you've got the movement, look forward and down between your hands. You can allow a little sway of the upper body here. So as it goes down, you rock back a little. And as it goes up, you shift forward a little. Keep leading with the knee, like we were in hip circles. Lift it up, 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 and straighten. If you're able to lift up with the knee and straighten at the end, you're gonna maximize your glute contraction. Let's take one more, hold it at the top, cross it down again. Now just switch your hands. Same exact move, down and up. We've changed the upper body. Hopefully you've noticed that we've now changed the work of the stance leg or the leg that's holding us up. For me, that's my left. It's getting hard. We can do this. Stick with that knee lifting up and then straighten at the very end. Match it with a glute squeeze. Think long lines and looking down. About 10 more seconds here, crew, and we're moving on. We've got one more move for this side. Coming down onto both elbows now, forearms parallel. Walk your elbows back towards your knee. Extend, flex foot out behind you. Tap that right knee down, and then extend back up. Tap, push, tap, push. It's hot here today. I didn't do much of a warm-up before this, but the sweat is already pouring. If you've already done a little bit of cardio before this, that's great. It leads you into the workout totally warm. This is perfect for after a run to really make sure we got a lot of great glute activation. We can do this, crew. Hang strong for 5 more seconds. Inhale down. Exhale, reach and squeeze. 2 and 1. Nice job on that side. Shins are parallel. Come up into kneeling. Lean back. Hover tuck. Hover tuck is an excellent move for the front of the thighs. Inhale down, exhale up. As you exhale up, tuck pelvis under, squeeze lower belly, squeeze glutes. We're gonna go into an isometric hold for 15 seconds starting here. Come to the top. Reach forward, slide back. We're holding here. We're feeling our front body grip. Hang on to that feeling. Lean back a little more. Come forward onto your elbows. Parallel lower arm bones. Plank. So for me, I feel a nice stretch in my calves. Quads are squeezing. Lower belly lifting up. Shoulders pushing away. We're gonna tap knees right and left. Getting a little bit of abdominal work in here. When we work our abdominals and our glutes and quadruped are all fours, it's essential that our abdominals are active. That'll make sure we get the right muscles working. Our back half and not our lower spine. 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower all the way down to your belly. Look to one side or straight down. Knees apart, heels squeezed together. Scoop your lower belly up. On an exhale, lift your heels to the ceiling. I call these froggers. When you're doing your froggers, keep your neck down and in neutral. in through the nose, out through the mouth, blow out the candles. Keep pulling lower belly up. Squeeze. Re-squeeze your heels. Squeeze your butt with your brain. Lift up. You've got 15 more seconds. And then we've got to do that same set of moves on the opposite side. Finish strong. 3, 2, 1. Take a quick child's pose. I'm going to turn around so you can see the opposite leg. Starting with hip circles on the opposite side. So I'm moving to the left side. Get yourself set. 4 and 4. I like to go backwards first and then reverse, come forwards. Keep pulling your body weight to the middle or to midline. Count your 4, then reverse. Try to make your reverse point from the top of the move, drop the foot, and then circle the other way. Light weight through the fingertips. Pull the weight back. Same hand behind the back. Lift that knee up. We turn our pelvis outwards. Circle backwards. We still have a bent knee. As you lift up and out through the stance glute, and then squeeze the outside of the moving butt cheek. Maybe your upper hand goes to your glutes. When we just think about the muscle we're contracting, we can contract more of the muscle fibers. Tap in. Almost there. Then we're going for that long lever lift. Get a couple more. I'm going to move slightly forward for this next one. Straighten that leg out, pointed toe. Lift, lift. So let's pretend that your leg, when it's in line with your body, that's your starting point. Try to lift it off the starting point. For some of us, weakness won't let us. For some of us, range of motion won't let us. But use that image. And each time you do this video, try to keep it a little bit higher. Exhale to lift. We can do this. Big time, outer thigh. Reach up and out through the chest. If you're shaking, that's a good thing. I'm shaking with you. Onto both hands again. Leg stays out behind you, toe pointed. Cross it behind, tap it to the outside of the mat. Lift it up and over and tap. Exhale as it goes over. Hip bones facing the mat. Beautiful half circles. If you want a spot check, you can put your opposite hand to your low back. Trying to make sure that the spine muscles are on, but we're not getting that big arch to go over. Sometimes what we can think about is the hand and leg that are down, try to get space between that shoulder and hip. If we crunch up through the side body, that's another compensation. 3, 2, 1. We're coming down onto the elbow and the hand. Oops, excuse me, not yet. Keep it out. Take it 2 inches to the outside, 2 inches to the middle. Lateral, out and in. Inhale it out, exhale, pull it back. 3 exercises in a row with a straight leg. Keep locking out your knee and trying to feel this right at that bottom crevice of your glute. If your hamstring is squeezing and you're mostly feeling it in your hamstring, take a break, come back, mentally squeeze your bum, scoop up your abs and jump back in. We've got a few more. Last one. Lower down, opposite elbow, cross the ankle behind, lift the knee up, extend. Curtsy, reach. So we said on the other side, a little counter from the trunk is okay. Shift back, shift forward, maybe about a total of 2 inches. Down, lift. Hang tight, guys. Hang strong, you can do this. We're gonna go for the same move, but we're gonna switch our arms. We're close. 3, 2, 1. Hold it up. If you can, switch while you're still lifted. This time, square the hip big time. Cross, reach. Cross, reach. If I were in class with you, I might come behind you and lift the bottom of the knee up, 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 straighten at the top. That way we're really focusing on that last bit of straightening being the work. I can use it too. This is a big time move where we've got to be super focused on form. Cross behind and lift. One more exercise on this side. We can do it. Exhale it up. Last one. All right, guys, both elbows. Walk the elbows back. Stick that leg up. Flex the foot. Tap the knee down. Lift it up. Tap down. Lift it up. So we're not lifting straight out and behind, but up to the ceiling behind us. Inhale, exhale. Visualize corner of the room. You've got a boxing bag. Kick it. With control. Sometimes in class I'll put my hand up and say, hit my hand. Hit my hand higher. We've got our elbows close to our knees. That's going to prevent too much low back involvement. Do one more. All right, guys, hover tuck. Whew, up on the knees. Lower legs parallel, tucking under. We're going to finish this strong. Hover tucks, planks, froggers. I am dripping. Let's get 3 more. 2, 1. Come to the top, tuck it under, hands out. Lean back. Feel that quadriceps squeeze. Get them warmed up. We want to use them in plank. Tuck under even more. Lean back even more. Tall spine. Almost there. All right, in the plank, forearms parallel. Squeeze it out, scoop your belly up, squeeze your quads, strong through the shoulders, walk the feet. Knees bend, gentle tap down. Lower belly's in and up. Pretend like someone just pulled a corset up and behind you towards the ceiling, right around your midsection. Quads should be screaming. Let's keep the legs the same. Come up into a tall plank position. Little upper body work. Lower down through your push-up. Bend the knees. Knees apart, heels together. Squeeze them. Abs are scooped. Exhale, lift. Forehead on not allowing your belly button to touch the floor. That much abdominal recruitment. Squeeze your heels even more. We can do this. This is awesome for the SI joint. If it doesn't feel good to lift, I just want you to squeeze. That's a great modification. Last little bit, crew. Here we go. 4, 3, 2. Let's hold this last one. Belly up, belly up, belly up. Squeeze your heels together. Lift your knees higher. Take your child's pose. All right, guys, nice job with your Pilates shorts workout. I hope to see you back again soon. Remember, come into these workouts warm, get them done, and we'll see you next class. Thanks.